In our example, we have a client and a server. The client wants to access some protected data on our server, but the server knows clients cannot be trusted. The server only wants to give the data to a trustworthy client. So our client sends a request to our server along with data to verify who it is. In our example, this user data was accepted as valid by the server. Now, instead of saving this user data, the server instead creates a token. This token is returned to the client, and it's up to the client to store this data and send it along as required for any request to the server. The next time our client makes a request along a secure route, it does just that. It sends along the JWT token. But our server knows not to trust a client because clients cannot be trusted. So our server verifies this token is who it says it's from and that it hasn't been tampered with. If everything checks out, like it does in our example, the server sends back a response with the requested data and everybody lives happily ever after. And that's a brief overview of how JSON web tokens work.